Our world lead now, a deadly mystery on the Hudson after the bodies of two sisters from Saudi Arabia were found bound together on the banks of the New York City River. Adding to the mystery of this tragedy is the fact that, according to the New York Times, the Saudi embassy told these sisters' mother that the girls had recently asked for political asylum, apparently so they wouldn't have to go back to Saudi Arabia. CNN's Athena Jones has the story.
A disturbing and bizarre mystery. How did two Saudi sisters, who had been living 250 miles away in Fairfax, Virginia, end up bound together with tape on the banks of the Hudson River in New York?
Seems odd. Seems like an odd way. I'm stunned.
New York police detectives say they have made significant progress in investigating the deaths of 16-year-old Tala Ferreira and her 22-year-old sister, Rotana Ferreira, but so far won't say whether they are treating this as a homicide.
Detectives have been down in Virginia. They've conducted a number of interviews in Virginia, including members of the immediate family, as well as others. And those interviews are really unraveling in some way a piece of the puzzle of behind the scenes what was going on in the two young ladies' lives.
The Saudi consulate in New York confirming Tuesday the sisters were Saudi citizens, saying in a statement that the young women were students accompanying their brother in Washington. Tala Ferreira was reported missing from Fairfax, just outside D.C., on August 24th, 2 full months before the sisters' bodies were found. And the New York Times, citing police, reports that the sister's mother received a call from the Saudi embassy in Washington informing her that her daughters had applied for asylum. This investigation comes just weeks after another Saudi citizen, Washington Post journalist Jamal Khashoggi, who had also been living in Virginia and was a critic of the Saudi regime, was killed in the Saudi consulate in Istanbul.
Now, the medical examiner is still working to determine the cause of death. Meanwhile, the Saudi consulate in New York says it has hired a lawyer to follow the case, and the State Department and Saudi Embassy in Washington are also following this investigation closely. Jake.
Athena Jones, thank you so much.